In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use your own remote control with a Kodi system on a Raspberry Pi. And it's not what you think. Stick around because you know what time it is. Now, Kodi has a great inbuilt system where you can use your existing TV remote through the HDMI signal called CEC. But that only works if you're using the same remote control through the same TV and so forth. But what I wanted to do is I wanted to grab a very minimalistic remote control like this one here and use it instead. So after a little bit of research, I did find that there was a device out there called the FLIRC USB device. So this will let you use any remote control with your devices. Now in my case, I'm going to demonstrate how to do this on a Raspberry Pi. However, you can use it on other systems that have a USB port. And to be honest, it wasn't as straightforward the first time I tried this. So what I'll do is we'll pop over to the computer and I'll show you how to do this properly. So the first thing you're going to want to do is jump over to the FLIRC website, and that is flirc.tv. Once you're there, go up to the top where it says Downloads, and when that page loads, make sure you choose your operating system version. You'll need to accept the terms and conditions by putting a tick in the box and then click on the latest version link. Once that's downloaded, we'll install the software. So click through all the prompts, and once you get to the very end, what we'll do is we'll launch the program itself. Now, before you launch the program, I highly recommend that you have the USB plugged in. And once the software loads, it will ask you to update the firmware. So what we'll do is we'll click yes here and we'll wait for a little while. Now, in my circumstance, it did take about 7.5 minutes. So I'd recommend to leave your computer alone for anywhere from 2 minutes to 10 minutes. Come back and check on it and it should have updated. Once it's updated, you'll see this screen here and you'll know that it's completely up to date. So now you can see that my remote is already pre-configured to use these keys here, but what we're going to do is we're going to expand it to use all the buttons. And to do that, we go to the controllers menu and go down to Kodi. And here what we can do is we can click on the corresponding key on the screen, and then it will ask us to press the key on the remote. This will record that successfully, if it does, and then we just go through and do it for every button that we want a button programmed for. So once you've keyed in all the buttons that you want to use with your remote in Kodi, that's pretty much it. We just need to quit the program, take out the USB, and we can pop that into our Raspberry Pi. So now that we've programmed the FLIRC USB device, what we can do is we can pop over to the Raspberry Pi and we can see how that works now. Okay, so going through the menu, you can see now that the buttons are working fine. And then if we go down to here and we press the volume button, you can see now that the volume up and the volume down works perfectly. So now you've got a minimalistic remote control using the FLIRC USB device on your Raspberry Pi controlling Kodi. How awesome is that? So do you have any questions or if you've got any comments that you want to share with me, then leave me a comment down below and let me know. Make sure you subscribe to this channel if you enjoyed this content. And also, if you are a subscriber, then make sure you hit that little bell icon so you can get notified of my new videos. And as always, imagine, learn, create.